Okay, let's do Android. Oh shit, that's Power Fist. Why is it default to Power Fist? That is not the next option. Why does it have such a slow fade out too? I don't even know. Oh, it's on random. Go figure. Jackhammer. This is gonna be rough, but we'll figure it out. Honestly, I think the AoE damage from me is gonna be good enough. But yeah, it does feel like the Saw Driver is by far the, like, hands down good item. So somebody was talking about, like, getting into the game and it's like, is it worth it? How do you do it? And it's just like, get Saw Driver, get the Jackhammer, kill everything, then learn how to play. Because that's how it works, as far as I can tell. Was that a bee? No? Wait, in my room? Maybe. I have no idea. My room is ridiculous. Wait, is there a bee character? I don't think so, unless I suddenly unlocked a bee somewhere along the way. Which seems wildly incomprehensible for me. And just genuinely unlikely. Oh, interesting tactic idea. Stay on the middle level. Leave the boxes alone. Let them drop down. Most of the explosives will never reach them. Interesting question. I have no idea. Well, I'll check to see if there's a bit. Jesus Christ, that's more explosions than I wanted to deal with. And more than I was expecting, too. Okay. Huh. No idea. No B so far. Where'd you come from? How much health do I... Oh, shoot. I got plenty of money. 1 minute in. Wow. How did it get so... I've been busting up all the boxes. And the boxes have been fairly forthcoming here. Pfft. TNT just goes zipping straight for the eyeball. Hey, I can't complain. I just would like a chest here. And there's a bug nibbling at my... Oh yeah, it is absolutely nibbling at my elbows, which I'm not appreciative of. Ooh, we get an extra jump. I don't know if this is going to save our butts, but it feels like it's going to get close. Okay, we've got just enough lightning that we don't have to worry about these things. Oh, and I've got a triple jump so I don't have to worry about getting up. Oh, maneuverability. Sweet, sweet maneuverability. Let's just stay well enough away from everything. I'm saying well enough a lot, but still. Okay. I'd love it if there was a B character. Honestly, I would love it if more games let you code in custom characters and stuff like that. Or at least custom skins. Like, I would totally just be like... I'd just totally be Shelby with, like, a... with a B skin, and you just have, like, a dongly-ass stinger just coming out of you after a while. That'd be ridiculous, but I'd be down for it. And, like, honestly, they'd totally just have to let you put in a custom sprite sheet for the same character. Which doesn't seem wildly impossible. Unlikely, though. That's actually one thing I really appreciate about certain games. Guacamelee actually lets you do it, which I think is kind of neat. Ow. Let's just stay away for a second. We've got things to... There we go. They're all dead. But I really appreciate that about Guacamelee, and it's part of one of the reasons... It's one of the reasons why I haven't specifically played the game yet. That and the fact that, you know, I want to play a co-op, and, you know, playing a co-op is, hard when you don't have a co-op partner on hand. But might be able to do it with Bird now. He might actually be able to, like, screen share with me. That would be fancy. Unlikely, but fancy. I would love that, but yeah, no. Character DLLs would be amazing. There's a lot of things that a lot of games could have that would just make things better. I mean, I can see why, like, custom items would be hard to do. Hard coding them in would be rough, to say the least. But, like, custom characters? I mean, heck, you could even have, like, a custom character with a custom ability if they just kind of opened it up and had, like, a bunch of sample abilities that you could, like, mix and match and stuff like that. Like, I'd love to have a character that's, like, that just has, like, oh, man. You know what would be a really cool character that isn't in the game? A character with, like, a... Character with a hang time jump that uses two guns, but, like, they're smaller and less effective. Like, I think it would actually be really cool if you couldn't use a melee weapon in this game. I guess it's kind of necessary if you want to dig down, though. Like, the whole digging part is kind of integral to the game, so I guess scratch that one. Just be pipe dream, I guess. Pipe dreamy? Yeah, pipe dreamy. Okay, what do we get? Oh, toxic flask. Yeah! Alright. So far, so great. Looks like Android is continuing her trend, is pretty close to Queen of the Arena. Because, yeah, we don't have to worry about half of the things sticking on us. And we got really lucky with that extra jump. Jesus Christ, everything dies. Okay. Let's just keep our distance for a little while longer. Take out these eyeballs. How are we doing money-wise? Beautifully. Okay. So far, so good. Yeah, so far, so great. I keep wanting to say it, and I have no idea why. Oh, well. That chest will just wait there for the time being. Let's get this health back. Oh, that's handy. That is hella handy. Come on. Give me what I want. Give me what I need. Give me all of that. All of that business. Because now we got the damage. Now we've got the power. Now we can actually rip through people pretty fast, too. Because we've got strike through, and we've got... Yeah, wow. That's like a... I want to say it's like a 10% boost. It's pretty high, comparatively. Unless it's like a flat... No. It's like exponential, I think. With the way the clumps of iron handle damage increases, which I'm totally down for. Okay. Let's just keep away from everything. Health is perfect. Flawless. Okay. Oh, yeah. Risk of rain with your own guy would be great. It'd be hard to do, though. Like, risk of rain would, I think, be a little bit harder, because, like, you don't... You have, like, each thing is, like, your own kind of unique weapon. Or your own... There's no, like, generic weapons to use for the character, no generic ability set. I'd be down with it, but it would just ultimately be a lot of work. And, I mean, realistically, the Risk of Rain guys are two people. Two people to make a game, and honestly, one guy did all the coding and the art himself. Ooh, hey, more jumps. So that, in and of itself, is almost more impressive. Ow. You know what? Let's just fuck everything. Die! Bastards. Oh, you're hurting more than I wanted you to. I want to get this health. I want to get all of this health. Why won't you let me have all of this health? Jerks. Okay, let's get another boxing glove, which is super not useful. Oh, well. Okay, let's go back to corralling. Jeez, what even happened there? I don't pretend to understand, but there's so many health pickups, I have to have them all. Look at that. Jeez. I am confused, but ultimately happy with it. Okay, more jumps. Hey, can't complain. Cannot complain at all. Okay. But no, I don't know. I guess I would just prefer to be able to custom skin effectively my own Wanderbot thing for the Android, so I could just be the Wanderbot. Same effect, but like I would totally do it just because, hey, I don't like the character design. It's like, why does the Android have just like hair? I've never understood that. Like, robots designed for Nuclear Throne doesn't bother me in the slightest because, I mean, it makes sense. Not so much in this one. I don't think it'll ever make a whole lot of sense to me. Ah! Yeesh. Oh, come on. Get out of my fucking way. Okay, there's just a lot of death here. Let's just blow everything up. Corral these guys. Yeesh! Health, 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 health. Whew. I have, like, no healing. I have no healing abilities. It's not like no healing abilities. I have no healing abilities, and there's a lot of people, and we're not getting a whole lot of loot here. Okay, at least we can kill the occasional one, and they're fairly forthcoming with loot. Come on, TNT. Destroy everything for me. Okay, well, that's a lot of toxic flasks and a book of secrets. Handy. So glad I have jumps. If we didn't have jumps, we'd be very much in trouble. Ooh, speaking of trouble. Oh, look at this. Look at all of this. All right, this is mildly to moderately insulting. More boxing gloves. The best, I guess. Okay. Luckily, corralling all of these stone guys actually results in quite a lot of health, assuming I don't get smacked around by them too much. They are quite a lot of damage if I'm not careful. Oh, hey, pilfer engine. Though at this point, I would argue I probably have more than enough money that buying things is not the hard part here. It's the getting to pick them up and then using them. Okay. Well, we get the phoenix freaking tail. Do we have any health here? Nope. Not even in the slightest. Okay. So far, so good. We've got more stuff. We've got a pilfer engine. That means more money, but that doesn't really matter. Okay. I'm getting like weird and rambly. This is hard. This is like, on one hand, this has been a very good run for me, just in terms of like the jumps. On the other hand, we're drastically underpowered, I think, for the current time period. We've got effectively 20 minutes to make up the difference between now and like ridiculous. Before the inevitable heat death of this game. Because, man, that frame rate always gets super wonky once I get past a certain point. It's part of the reason why I actually tried going with this combo. Because it's the saw driver especially is like really, really rough in terms of like functionality and like performance. So, geez, look at all these stone dudes just rolling around down here. There's an insane amount of them. That said, it's great money. I just wish I could kill them faster. Oh boy. Well, I guess I can just let everything explode and hope for the best. It's working. It's surprisingly working well. This is rough. Oh, see you, Killer Q. Have a good one. Ow. Okay, buy more chests. Oh, black hole box, you are the handiest. Double black hole box, yes! Oh, hey, money is power. Money shot. This is where things start turning around. If only I had healing. I think that would be the best. Okay, what is this? Black hole box, bombs, squad armor, and yes! Okay, this is where stuff starts turning around. Our luck is changing really hard, really fast, actually, and suddenly we're full health. Suddenly we're no longer full health. This is just the smorgasbord of just damage. Damn. Alright, well, whatever. I do like 100 damage per shot, and that's exactly what we need. Pretty soon we'll be able to start one-shotting things. Getting a spread shot would be handy. Getting all these books of secrets, though. Okay, yeah, we're looking so far so good, comparatively, to what we were just a little bit earlier. This isn't Isaac. Shouldn't be Isaac. Try refreshing your page if it says I'm still playing Isaac. Also, I like how large my kick beam cannon shots. Damn. I don't know exactly what does that. It must be like an enemy that explodes. But every once in a while something explodes and it's just like, everything just died over here. Have like 40 items and it's just like, okay. I can't complain. Okay, I did get the bomb squad armor. I was worried about that for a second. Okay. Do I have any healing yet? Nope, not a single one. We've just got a lot of damage and a lot of armor. And a lot of magnetism, which I think is the main draw. Should probably actually purchase from this chest. It's more boxing gloves! Is anybody surprised? Nobody should be surprised at this point. It's ridiculous how many boxing gloves I've made. There we go. There's our healing. Beautiful. Just in time, too. Look at all these guys coming in. There's some kind of bug crawling around my arm. Anyway. Just called it Money is Power instead of Money Shot. Let's be honest here. Oh, I see. Money's Power versus Money Shot. Let's be honest here. Money's Power, Golden Gun, Money Shot, they're all the same thing. It's just the more money you have, the more damage you do. So, there you go. Okay. We're not healing as much as I'd like to. Luckily, the Bomb Squad armor is keeping me very much alive. We've got plenty of cash, so our damage is probably getting really high up there. Because I do not think Money Shot has like a... Oh, thank you. I don't think Money Shot has an upper limit. Okay, so I think at this point we won't be taking too much damage. Our iframes have been... I assume it's like doubling or something like that. I don't know. The goo orb thing is ridiculous. I'm taking some heavy hits, though. I'm just kind of trying to hide in the corner and just... Oh, wow. Look at all this armor rolling in. There we go. There's the first of the beetles. That's what we need. Perfect. Game is fun. Ah, man. I really hope they actually get the performance on the arena working. I would love to do like a 2-hour arena run at something at some point like that. The problem is like there's no easy way for it to work. I just enjoy like dealing with this like large of an enemy group. At the same time, it's entertaining. But it's super unlikely to even work. Look at all of this. Something's gonna explode in here. There we go. Nope, it's not all dead. They're not all dead yet. This is super impressive. What did I even pick up? Bomb squad armor and another vigor beetle. Yeah! Alright, well. Should probably pick this up. I'm trying to think of, like, ways to make this game better. Really just kind of this mode better. Because, like, as much as I like it, it does get unfeasible after a certain point. I think it's truly the special effects. Like, actually, you know what? If this game had, like, almost a limit to the number of... special effects that would pop up. That'd probably help a lot. I don't even know. But yeah, I definitely do love all the chaos. It's really fun. And you know what? I actually, over the Steam Summer Sale, I did actually buy several... Oh, wow. Yeah, I did buy quite a lot of games that I need to start covering, like Sunless Sea, Massive Chalice, several shmups that I'd like to get into, because shmups are fun. Okay, there's a black hole box, if I can get it. Perfect. Several shmups. Oh, shoot. Either there's another chest in there. So many black hole boxes. Well, there's going to be nothing left over. Oh, see a Reaper of Caliban. Have a good one. Is that more? Nope. Just bunches and bunches of Giga Drills. That's not handy. That's not even remotely useful. I'm surprised I haven't gotten a second shovel or, you know, spreadshot. Or burst fire. Did they take... They must have taken burst fire out of the game. I have not seen it since the major patch. Which is kind of a shame. It actually seemed like it was moderately functional towards the end there, for some mysterious reason. Oh, these are handy items. Oh, these are all handy items. Perfect. Unfortunately, that chest did not give me a duplicate of what I wanted. Oh well. At this point, I can just live. Yeah, sunless sea. I'm really looking forward to it. I'm kind of hoping it turns out well. I'm kind of hoping that it's a lot of fun. It looks like they're still developing it too, which is super nice for me. So I'm probably going to load that up tomorrow night. If anything, I don't know. I need to like restructure some of my like streaming recording practices, which might end up like being me streaming slightly less at night, but starting to stream midday as well. Because I'd love to, I don't know, I need to figure out how exactly to fit everything in. Because I'd like to do art streams too, those are just slightly harder. But I guess I can do them while games render. Nope. Well, I can't do that with painting. I can do it with vector though, I can totally do that with vector. Look at all these dudes, just wait, cruising for a bruising. But the problem is like during the day is usually when I upload, so either option A, well, I mean first and foremost, I think what I need to do is actually sit down and have like a really long recording day. Wow, look at whatever the hell just died over there. I think I need to have a really long recording day. And it might be tomorrow, might be Tuesday. Kind of midday, where I get up a little bit earlier. And then I just record for hours and get a backlog again. Because I do not have a backlog and it has been hurting for so very long. Because I actually really like, I really like streaming and I really like streaming like whatever I want, but it's also one of those where it's just like, I need to catch up with everything. So, actually, I know probably tomorrow's just gonna be Batman. I think tonight's gonna be Batman, too. Hey, there we go, double shovel, finally! Perfect! I have no idea what time it is. It is 4:13. Okay, yeah, so as soon as this run ends, which I'm probably gonna give it to the point where it starts chugging, and then I'm just going to seppuku. Harikiri? I don't know. There's gotta be somebody Japanese watching, or at least somebody that knows the proper phrase for, you know, just honorable suicide. So, I always hear seppuku. In fact, what's the difference between seppuku and harikiri? I have no idea. None whatsoever. That's an interesting question. Well, either way. But, no, I need to catch up with Batman. I've been putting out two episodes of Batman a day since, what, Saturday? So I guess the past 2 days. And, like, Arkham Knight comes out on Wednesday. And that's going to be a long stream day. That's probably going to be one of those where I'm like, alright, I'm going to be busy. Pretty much the whole day. Streaming time! And then I'm going to have to worry about hard drive space. Yeah, gotta prep all that stuff. If you ever do YouTube and you ever, like, want to do YouTube... Oh, cool. I got a Vortex Shard. Two of them. If you ever, like, are doing YouTube, make sure you always have enough hard drive space for everything. Otherwise, shit's just gonna get really inconvenient. Because the problem is just ultimately, I have like a 2 terabyte hard drive. It's already full. It's been full for a while. I've just been like kind of pulling emergency measures. And I like this can end up being like a quarter of that to an eighth of that. And it's just like, you don't have space. Do we get anything cool from this? The answer is a level up. And Jin Zephyr Horns. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Okay, seppuku is the more formal name that you'd see in like documents and stuff. Harikiri is less formal and what people might say in informal settings. Alright, that's good to know. Oh, hey, I gotta get over here and get this stuff. Oh, the bosses are starting to show up. That means we're going to get some really chuggy physics. Pretty soon. Oh well, let's make the most of what we got. I don't know where the boss is gonna, if and when the boss is gonna show up. Yep, there he is. And he is now stuck in the quagmire. You dunce. That said, this does make it a little bit easier on us because now we don't have to shoot very far. I wonder actually if this, no, we've definitely been this far with this weapon combo before. So it's not like we're doing anything particularly new. Well, we're almost there. We're almost to the point where it's just death time. I'm kind of disappointed I haven't gotten a second shot here. Because I'd love to be able to fire off like 7 of these. But it looks like it's not chugging quite yet. We're getting there quick. We're getting there very fast. And someday this game will be like fully optimized, then we won't have to worry about it. For now, oh hey, there's our spread shot. Perfect. Another drill. Yeah. Death to everybody. Truly. This is glorious. Okay. I think at this point, we're only going to run into performance issues left and right. Yeah, let's get to the 20-minute mark and then kill ourselves, because, like, that worm is going to get stuck in one of our abyss vortexes, and then it's just going to be bad. It's going to be very bad. Oh, vortex shard. There we go. Well, let's just grab whatever loot we can, even though we're probably quitting within the next 3 minutes. Oh, there he is. You shall not pass. I always feel bad for him, just like squeegeeing him up into this tiny little zone. It's just like, nope, you cannot escape. This is a no passing zone. This is where you get stuck. This is where you die. Just accept it. What if I did more damage, if this would be less of a problem? Probably, but I don't think I get much of a choice. I don't think I'm ever going to be damaging enough that I can just like one-shot even a boss. I wonder if he would actually perform better if he... No, that would probably be bad. Each of his segments takes damage, but they don't have their own individual health bars. That'd actually be really cool if you could, like, break him down that way. Okay, well, so far, performance seems to be okay. We'll see how far we can go, because I do actually really enjoy this game. And I really do enjoy arena mode. Oh boy, look at all this stuff come in. Let's destroy these guys. These guys are probably going to give me more than enough loot. Yep, there we go. It's also nothing but, like, gigamech worms for some reason. No eyeballs. And then that weird cube thing. I actually kind of wish that roving box... hello. I really wish that roving box would actually show up in arena mode, too. It doesn't really make sense that it doesn't. I mean, sure, it has, like, a specific arena in, like, the actual gameplay, but jeez. This is where the loot starts coming in. Unfortunately, this is also where the gameplay stops working so well. How many things do I even fight? A fire. I fire 5 kickbeam cannon shots at the same time. Well, this is ridiculous. He's been stuck in that corner for the past, like, minute or so. Probably a little bit less than that, but, like, I actually stopped paying attention to the boss with the expectation that he'd get freed from it. No such luck. Ooh. Well, that was rough. Look at those items roll in. Not actually as much as I thought it would be, but still. How much damage does this even do? Doesn't actually say. Not nearly as much as it should. Not nearly as informative as I would like it to be. Oh well, not the end of the world. How many black gold boxes do I have? 16! That might actually be the most extent of what we have. It's very hard to tell. Well, let's just destroy everything. Ooh, look at all the worms roll in. Hey, worms! How are you guys doing? You know what would actually be really neat? If, in adventure mode, between cycles, you actually got to go to the arena for, like, 5 minutes. And it'd be like this, where you're just getting, like, swamped with stuff, but you're getting loot left and right. That'd be fascinating, but I guess it would probably also crash the game, so I guess I can see why you wouldn't want to do that. Ugh. Well, either way. Oh, shoot! Extra shovels! Better get those, even though I don't need to. Even though, like... At this point, this run is so in the bag that it doesn't even matter. In fact, it's detrimental for me to even get any more items, but I don't have a choice. How much health do I have? 5, oh Jesus. I just got a whole slew of items and they're still coming. Look at them cycle in. Damn. Alright. Just grab and grab more stuff. Well, I think we just like tripled our item count in one very, very fluid motion. Which I do not regret. And now the frame rate is better. Yay! It's only going to last for 20 seconds. Maybe a minute at best. Until something else decides to blow up. And then we're doomed again. It definitely does feel like the clock has slowed down a little bit. Because I swear it's taken like 2 minutes. 2 to 5 minutes to get up. 1 or 2 minutes. I don't know. We'll see. Let's see, Golem Core. We've got 8 Vortex Shards right now. We're gonna need more if we want to pull in the boss, though he currently is stunlocked up there. So I guess that's not exactly encouraging in terms of, like, his stability. to say the slightest. So I'm just gonna keep tootling on. Remember when it was so hard for me to get up into the center platform, and then it's just like, all right, let's just... Oh, hey, that's one of the little biter bugs. They're tiny and very painful. Item overload, absolutely. Oh, we have removed him from his perch. And now, time to mess up performance to the point where this game is generally unplayable. I'm going to be a Christmas tree. Look at all this damage. Everything just, like, sucks into me and then just dies. It's glorious. Alright, we're down to 16 frames a second. This is super doofy. Did we kill him? We killed him! Okay, so we get some C4, and I think at this point is a great time for me to say, death to everything! Bye. Why? Because I could just keep going. I really could, but I think this run was only going to grind itself to a halt, and I actually kind of, after a certain point, it stops being fun. It's just like, alright, let's just sit here shooting at things. The first 10 minutes of the arena is the best part, maybe 15, and then by the end of it, it's like, I like the chaos, but then it culminates in just being unable to do anything, which is kind of a shame. I don't know. Maybe less enemies in the arena, more enemies in regular mode? No clue. Either way, I will see you guys in the next episode of Cavern Kings, and as always, thanks for watching.